In this video, I want to go over what's been happening the past couple of days. A few videos back, I mentioned that we're going to be carrying this box that contains 100 different types of charging ports, 5 pins, 7 pins, 11 pins, USB-C port, USB 3.0 port, so on and so forth. Now, it's been very difficult knowing what charging ports to carry or what's out there. I want to carry as many charging ports as we can. I mean, one charging port can work on 100 different devices, but we do not know which device this charging port will work on. I do not want to just fill this box with charging ports and mail it over to you. It's going to be very difficult to know what charging port to use on what specific device. I contacted a lot of factories, many of them in China and Hong Kong, and I'm trying to get as much information as I can on what device each port supports. A lot of factories do not have that information. They just sell the ports. Let's say you are working on a device and you want to find a specific port for that device. I do not want you to keep opening drawers to see which port, which drawer contains which port, which drawer contains which port. I want to make this as easy as possible. So I am sorting this in a way where we're going to label the drawers from 1 to 100. I think we're going to have about 100 different types of charging ports, more or less. But I want to be able to label those drawers, and the labeling will be the same for everyone. So if I tell you drawer number 1 supports, let's say, Samsung Note 4, then it's going to be the same for everyone. I do not want to just randomly put charging ports in the drawers. The next thing is I'm going to be taking pictures for all 100 different models. This one contains 5,000 charging ports here. We have 10 of those boxes. We have boxes here, which is going to be the same as this. So what I'm thinking about doing is I'm going to take 100 pictures, one picture for each model. And those pictures will be posted on our site. Let's say you are looking for a specific charging port. You know how that charging port looks like. You know the shape of the charging port. Then you can scan through the images that we have in a very easy way. And once you find that charging port that you are looking for, it will show on the image that this charging port is number 25. You open this box here, you look for number 25, and you are able to use that port. Let's say you are looking for a specific charging port. For example, a few days back, I was working on a Samsung baby monitor that came in for a broken charging port. I went to look for a charging port for that device, and I was not able to find it anywhere online. But I know how the shape of that charging port looks like. Now, chances are you will have that charging port in one of the 100 compartments that we have here. But how can you tell which charging port will work on that device? I want to do this in a way where it's very efficient to find the charging port that you are looking for based on the shape of the actual charging port. I want to be able to find a specific charging port as fast as possible. Now, sorting is number one, and that's what I've been doing for the past couple of days. Again, the box will be sorted from 1 to 100, more or less. And the next thing is we need to know which port supports which device, and that's the hard part. Now, I compiled a list here, and this list is based on my experience and my effort figuring out which port supports which device. A lot of the information I was able to get from a lot of factories out there, but most of the factories are from China and Hong Kong, and they gave me a list of devices. For example, the charging port number 47 supports Oppo RA270. I do not know what Oppo is. Maybe it's a device that's used in China. I do not really care much about this device, but the information is there. I know that port number 47 supports Oppo RA270, X909T, R6007, U701T, so on and so forth. Charging port 52, it supports Galaxy Fame, S6810, so on and so forth. Charging port 54 supports the HP Slate 7 tablet. Charging port number 55 supports Acer Iconia A1810. For example, we have port number 56. That's USB 3.0 port. It's used on most of the external hard drives that you find out there. 22, it supports Oppo X907. I do not know what Oppo is. I never fixed an Oppo phone. Maybe this is a popular device in Asia. I do not know. I do not really care about this device, but it's there. The information is there. The same charging port or the same connector may work on 50 other devices. We do not know what device that port works for. So in the future, we're going to compile a bigger list, and the list will keep growing. If you figure out that port number 27 supports, let's say, Note 4, I want you to let me know that port number 27 supports Note 4 so I can add it onto the database. It will help you in the future, and it will help others who also have the same box. Now, I spent a lot of time working on this box, sorting through the connectors. gathering all the information about which charging port supports which device. Of course, this list is going to grow in the future. And I'm thinking, what is a good price to put on this box? From my experience, anytime I want to buy a charging port, I go on eBay. I do not buy it from China. I do not buy it from Asia, because the customer cannot wait. A customer will wait 3 to 5 days. I will get the shipment from eBay within 2 to 5 days. From my experience, I pay about $3 a charging port from eBay. If I'm lucky, I'll find somebody who's selling the charging port in bulk, 20 pieces, and maybe I'll end up paying $1.50 per charging port. But normally, on average, it's $3 to $5 per charging port when I buy it from eBay. Now, I bought 50,000 charging ports. We got a good deal. We have to consider shipping cost. We have to consider customs. We have to consider the 3% credit card fee that we get charged. We have to consider the time I spent working on this. We have to consider the price of the box, which is currently going about $27 on Amazon. I do not want to overwhelm you with all the hidden costs that goes on behind the scenes. I want to just charge one flat price for this box. And after doing a lot of thinking, we're going to be charging 38 cents per port flat. So 500 ports times 0.38, and you're not going to be able to get ports for 38 cents anywhere from the US, guaranteed. So this box will be sold for $190. $190 includes the 500 ports that's inside the box. That's 100 different models times 5. Price includes the box. The price includes free shipping and handling. The price includes all the stuff that we paid to make this box happen. So $190 flat to get this box shipped to your door. This box will start to ship out early next week. We still have to fill all the boxes with all the ports. Big Box has a lot of work to do. So I would say the box should start to ship out maybe on Monday or Tuesday, more or less. And we already have a lot of pre-orders. A lot of people already paid for the box. I'm gonna post a link in the description on where you can buy this box. You can pre-order now and the box will ship out early next week. If we ran out of those boxes, it's not the end of the world, but we do have to wait about a month or two before we start selling those boxes again. It's going to take time to resort and regroup and package all those components. So if you want one of those boxes, you can go ahead and buy it right now. And hopefully you're able to get one from this batch. We also received this amp meter, and this amp meter is used to find out how much amps is being drawn by a phone, by a tablet, by a USB-C device, by a USB-C laptop, so on and so forth. Let's say I'm working on a MacBook that has a USB-C connector, or I'm working on an HP Spectre, or I'm working on an Asus laptop that has a USB-C connector. We can plug this amp meter in the laptop and we can tell how much amps are being drawn. By the charger, we can tell the voltage if it's at a 5-volt state, or at a 20-volt state, or at a 15-volt state, or at a 12-volt state, so on and so forth. With this amp meter, you can buy this optional USB-C adapter. I'll show you what that is. Now, for example, I have a Galaxy Note 9 here. Let's say I want to charge it, and I want to know how much amps is being drawn by that phone. This is a USB-C connector. So in order to use the USB-C plug here, you have to have a USB-C adapter. This is the same USB-C adapter that you use to maybe charge your phone or laptop or whatever the case may be. What we need to do is plug the USB-C cable onto the USB-C adapter. And the USB-C cable, you see, if you look in here, we have a regular USB cable and we have a USB-C connector here. So if we plug the USB-C cable here and we plug it onto the phone, if you look at the meter, we have a big, nice display of the voltage. So the phone is currently charging at 1.7 amps, and that's fast charging. You have MAH, and you have the time. Now, you have the mode here to show different readings on the screen, but let's keep it at voltage, current, MAH, and time. Let's say I want to store what's on the screen. You have 9 different memories inside this meter. So let's go, let's press on read. This is memory number 0, memory number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. You have 9 different memories inside. Let's say I want to save what's on the screen. Just press and hold read. and now it's saved on memory number 0. Let's say you press and hold read again, it's going to save it on memory number 1. So let's press and hold. Now it's saved it on memory number 1. If you want to go over what was saved, just press on read. So that's memory slot number 1. That's what I saved the first time. Press again, that's what I saved the second time. And now we have zeros on the rest of them because I did not save anything there. Let's say you want to clear what's here. Just press and hold. And it's going to clear all of them. So 1, 2, everything is cleared. Very easy to use. The amp meter is just awesome. Just awesome. I used to use the Klein amp meter that you see here, which looks similar, but the display on this one is a lot better. I bought this one off Amazon for $29. This one here will be sold for about the same price, and this one is a lot better. Bigger display, backlit, and just an awesome amp meter. So this will be posted on the website for sale also. We have about 12 different things that we got that will be posted on the site. The past week has been overwhelming, a lot of overtime hours. Big Boss is working overtime hours also. He does not leave home even when I tell him to just go and relax. He stays with me and he wants to get things done. We have a lot of things to fix. We have a lot of mailings. I still have to do YouTube. I still have to spend time with family. Today, I barely had time for lunch. It's almost 7 o'clock right now. We close at 6. And I think I'm going to end it right here. I'll make an official video when we have the box ready just to go over the ports that we have inside. And maybe by that time, I would have taken all the photos of the charging ports. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I know this is not a repair video, but I had to do it because of the overwhelming number of emails we've been getting about this box. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and we'll do something else in the next video.